Thank you so much, everybody. How we doing, Montreal? What an honor to be here, ladies and gentlemen. Listen, I am so proud to say that next year I will be celebrating 20 years working in television. Unbelievable. And that's amazing. I mean, I'm kind of freaked out by it. You know what my first TV gig was? Working in children's television. I worked on a show called YTV. Does anybody know YTV? Oh, that's a great place to start if you're planning on getting into becoming a Canadian celebrity, I'll tell you that. And I'll never forget the first time I got recognized. It was amazing. I was so proud. My show had aired, and this little child walking down the street, he spotted me. I was like, this is it. And so yeah, he comes running up and he's like, oh my goodness. Excuse me, mister. Oh my goodness. Are you the guy that's on the television? Are you the guy on YTV? And I was like, yeah, that's me. Who do I make it out to? And he was like, you suck! And he kicked me in the balls and he ran away. Canadian celebrity. That's what it's like. I mean, it's so different than anywhere else. Canadian celebrity is so different than American celebrity. Like in America, if you have your own TV show, guess what? You never have to audition again. They just give you shows. In Canada, you could be the star of the most successful television show in the history of Canadian television, and you still have to audition for the Kraft cheese slice commercials. It's true, and you could be at home watching the sitcom that you're starring in, right? There it is, boom, this gigantic. You're watching this show, the most successful show ever. Your cheese commercial comes on, and people watch and won't even recognize the guy in the cheese commercial as the same guy in the freaking sitcom. That's Canadian celebrity. In America, you know you've made it, okay? When you get your own billboard and you buy your first multi-million dollar home. In Canada, you know you've made it when you no longer live in Canada. It's sad but true. Sad but true. I guess I've made it. I moved to the United States, ladies and gentlemen. It's not that I don't love Canada, but I did. I moved down there. And I got to say, you know, these stereotypes about Canadians, they still exist, you know. Oh, yeah, you guys live in igloos. It's funny. Okay, whatever. Yeah. Celine Dion. Okay, that's funny. Yeah. That's how it used to be. You know what it is now? Now it's like, oh, yeah, you're from Canada. Oh, yeah. Crack Mayor Rob Ford. I'm like, what? No. Yeah, crack mayor Rob Ford. Yeah, you know, he's that homophobic, racist, crack smoking mayor. He's the mayor of Canada. I'm like, no, we live in igloos. Oh, yeah, Celine Dion, she's our prime minister. Oh, yeah. We're hockey playing, beer drinking, communist, healthcare loving, polite people, you jerk. That's right. No, we've got to reinvent. That's what we gotta do. We gotta reinvent our stereotypes, right? Did you know this is a good one to have, right? We are the most same-sex marriage-friendly country in all of North America, and that's a good thing. You know, the US, they're a little bit behind. Mexico, pfft. Right? Mexico, el pupu de culo es para en salidas, no entradas. Look it up on your app. No, we should be thankful, you know, we have same-sex marriage here. Other countries would just die to have. People in friggin' Africa, they're starving for same-sex marriage. Canada's going hog wild with it right now, too. It's so great for our country. Because Canada's actually thinking about, you know, what they're going to do. They're going to start forcing people to get gay married. Oh, yeah. It's going to be legislated. It's going to be amazing. And there's nothing wrong with it, right? It's going to be a mandate. So here's the law. Here's how it's going to go. If you're a guy and you live with another guy for more than 6 months, boom, you're gay married. Yeah. It's going to be a mandate. I guess it'll be called uncommon law. Well, wow. I just feel bad for, you know, all the Newfoundlanders who are working up in Fort Mac, Alberta. You know, the guys who are up there working on the oil fields. That's going to be awkward, right? Once that law takes effect. It's going to be a weird phone call to make back home. Oh, yeah. Hey, Ma. Yeah, listen, I just got my tax return back. Turns out I'm homosexual. Yeah, no. Same thing happened to my roommate, Steve. Yeah, you know Steve, the pipe fitter. Yeah.
Yeah, no, that was the lube specialist. Yeah. Yeah, so anyway, we've adopted a Chinese baby. Get the room ready. We'll be home at Christmas. Right? Yeah. Give it up for Rig Pigs.